Good afternoon, dear friends. Let's learn the another story, The Midnight Visitor. The Midnight Visitor, the story which is written by Robert Arthur. And let us have the little information about the author. Robert A. Arthur Jr. was a mystery and speculative fiction writer known for The Mysterious Traveler radio series and his Three Investigators series of novels. He was born on November 10, 1909. He was very amazing story writer. He contributed many stories, many novels in American English literature. He was died in Philadelphia in US in 1969. Now about the story, The Midnight Visitor. You see, in this story there are three characters. Those three characters are very active characters. Very first character is Osebel, who is a very dexterous spy espionage. Second, Max. Who is Max? Max is another spy. Then Fowler. Fowler is a journalist. Now you understand here, he stays in a hotel, and Fowler, who is a journalist, he goes to Osebel to take his interview, who is a detective, spy, espionage. Now in this story, there are two passive characters. Those are waiter and police. Actually, these two characters are not involved in the story, but we feel their presence. Okay, now it is about characters. Now in this story, you see Osebel, a secret agent, is expecting to get a very important report. Another secret agent, Max, threatens him with a pistol, demanding the report. Does Osebel outwit him? Now you see, another dimension of the story is appearances are deceptive. Appearances are deceptive. It means, what do we see? It's not reality. See, generally we have a certain conditioned mind about everything. When we look at a police or a defense personnel, then we feel very tall, smart, healthy personality. But in Osebel, we find all these contrasts. He is not fit to the detective profession, but his work proved that he is one of the greatest detectives. Okay, so here appearances are deceptive. These dimensions also we are going to learn. Now you see here, in this story, Osebel is a detective. Fowler is a writer who wants to write a book on detectives. Here you understand who is Osebel and who is Fowler. Osebel, he is a detective. And Fowler, he wants to write a story book. He wants to write a book. So he goes to interview Osebel, to meet Osebel. But after meeting Osebel, Fowler is very disappointed, as Asebal is a very fat man, and he does not match any details that Fowler has read in the books about the detectives. You see, when he met to Asebal, he gets disappointed. Why does he get disappointed? He finds a total contrast in Asebal and what did he read about detectives in many books. He feels he doesn't find any match to Asebal. Those characteristics, specialities which were read by him. When they reach at Otto Asebal's room, Fowler gets thrilled to find another person named Max inside the room with a gun in his hand. And when both of them entered into the room, then Fowler, what did he notice? He noticed there was a person already in the room who was another secret, who was another secret agent named Max, and who has a pistol in his hand. Fowler gets thrilled to find another person named Max inside the room with a gun in his hand. Max looks like a fox. Max came there to take report about the missiles from him. And why did he come? Why did Max come into Asebal's room? To collect, to snatch the missiles report from Asebal. Asebal deceives Max and tells him about the nuisance caused by the balcony near his window. And how did he outwit Max? That he made believe Max to window, nearby window there is a balcony. So he made believe in him. Max believes him, and when someone knocked at the door, Asebal says that it might be police. Max gets frightened and he tries to hide behind the window, but he falls down and cries loudly. There was no police at the door, but he was a waiter who fetched 2 glasses and a bottle of wine. Thus Max has fallen down from a room on the 6th floor. So very credulously Max was cheated, he was deceived, and he was outwitted by Asebal. And there Fowler, he understood the intelligence, the brilliancy of Asebal. And though his appearance doesn't match to be the very handsome detective, but his work, his presence of mind really outwitted Max and proved himself as the best detective. So it is about the story. Once again, you see here, Asebal is a detective in the story. Fowler is a person who had come to Asebal to write a book on detectives. Fowler was disappointed to see Asebal, as he could not find any quality in him that he had read about detectives. When they entered the room and Asebal switches the light on, they find Max inside the room with a gun in his hand. He looks like a fox. Max wants to take the report about the missiles from Asebal. Asebal cleverly changed the topic to divert his attention. He says that this was the second time for the nuisance caused by the balcony. Suddenly, a waiter knocked at the door, and Asebal said that it might be police to provide him protection because of that report. Max got frightened Max tells them that he will wait outside the balcony and jumps out of the window of the balcony. As he jumps, they hear him fall and cries loudly. Ausable tells Fowler that it was a waiter who came to serve his order and there was no balcony. So, dear children, so very smartly, Ausable, he outwitted Max, and there was no balcony outside of the window, but he believed, he diverted his topic and made Max believe that there was a balcony. And when the door was knocked, he wanted to hide and he jumped into the balcony, but there was no balcony. He fell off the ground and he died. You see, very skillfully, very dexterously, very adroitly, Ausable finished off his opponent, and Fowler got impressed. So it is the story of the it is the theme of the story, the Midnight Visitor. Okay, now dear children, in this story glossary, you see some words you must know it, and those words: romantic, it means imaginative, having a fantastic view of reality. Passably, just well enough, tolerably well. Espionage, spying. Sloppy, carelessly dressed. Prozac, ordinary. Chuckled, laughed quietly without opening his mouth. Wheezed, spoke, breathing noisily and heavily. Missiles, weapons directed by remote control or automatically. Shrilly, piercingly in a high pitch. Okay, so dear children, these are words you must know it. Okay, now in this story, you see, Ausable did not fit any description of a secret agent Fowler had ever read, but his presence of mind proved as the best detective. Okay, then Ausable managed to make Max believe that there is a balcony attached to his room. So his diversion, his presence of mind also is very impressive. You see, Ausable shows great presence of mind, or the ability to think quickly and act calmly and wisely in a situation of danger and surprise. See, like Ausable, we should not get panicked. We should keep ourselves very calm and quiet. And during the crisis, in the difficult situation, we must take action very calmly. Then we can overcome through all those difficulties. Okay, so you see, presence of mind comes out of a state of mental preparedness. You see, calmness is very important to our mind. Then only innovative ideas come out and we can execute those ideas. So dear children, in our day-to-day life also, we sometimes come across many difficulties, calamities, and in such situation we should not lose our mind, we should not get confused. Those things, suppose a small fire starts in our kitchen, we should not get panicked. We must take the correct remedy. A child starts to choke on a piece of food. An electrical appliance starts to hiss and gives out sparks. A bicycle knocks down a pedestrian. It rains continuously for more than 24 hours. A member of your family does not return home at the usual or expected time. So these are panicked situations, but we should not lose our temper in this panicked situation, and we must keep ourselves controlled, and like Ausable, very smartly we must outwit we must get through the difficulties. So it is the general theme of this story. Okay, so dear children, you read it and listen to it and act on it. Thank you.